Hello students, today we are going to study the poem, a photograph of our book, Hornbill. The poem, A Photographer, is written by Shirley Tolson. In this poem, she recalls her mother and her memories while looking at a childhood photograph when her mother was 12 years old or so. She has been deceased 12 years ago, and she cannot explain her grief on her mother's loss. Now the poem. The cardboard shows me how it was when the two girl cousins went paddling, each one holding one of my mother's hand, and see the big girl some 12 years or so. In these lines, the poet is looking at an old photo album which is made up of cardboard. In the picture, there are three girls who are walking on the beach holding each other's hand. The girl in the middle is the tallest and oldest. The other two girls on each side are younger than her. The girl in the middle is the poet's mother. She is around 12 years old when the picture was taken. All three stood still to smile through their hair at the uncle with the camera, a sweet face, my mother's, that was before I was born, and the sea, which appears to have changed less, was their terribly transient feet. Here, the poet describes how the photograph was taken. Her mother's uncle took the photograph and told them to stop and pause. All three of them left their wet hair open and smiled at the camera. The poet's attention is drawn towards his mother's face, which is described as a sweet face. The photograph was taken long before the poet was born. The poet calls their feet terrible transit, as they were so young by then and now they had grown older. On the other hand, the sea, which touched their feet, has changed less. Some 20-30 years later, she would laugh at the snapshot. See Betty and Dolly, she would say, and look how they dressed up for the beach, the sea holiday. In these lines, after 20-30 years later, she would laugh at the photograph. She would tell me to look at her cousins, Betty and Dolly, and how their parents would dress all three of them up for the beach. They would have planned to take a photograph beforehand. Was her past, mine is her laughter, both re with the labored ease of loss. The poet recalls the sea holiday was her mother's favorite moment from the past, while the poet's favorite moment from the past was her mother's laughter. Both the women would think about those past memories which they cannot live again. They tried their best to adjust to what they lost. Now she's been dead nearly as many years as that girl lived, and of these circumstances there is nothing to say at all. It silence silences. In these lines, the poet says that her mother died 12 years ago, the same age her mother was in the photograph. Whenever the poet thinks of her mother's death, she cannot explain what effect she has of her mother's death. Death was silenced. Death has silenced her mother, which has also left her speechless. Now look at the some literary devices used in this poem. Stood still through there my mother's a terrible transit. You know, when the two consecutive words begins with the same letter, when they have the initial same sound, they are called alliteration. Terribly transit, when the expression used in the line denotes something else. Here terribly transit shows the existence of human being is very short as compared to the nature. When such phrases are used, it is called epithet. Labored is when two contrary words used. So in such cases, it is oxymoron. And at last, silence silences. Again, the two words starting with the same initial sound. So here it is alliteration. Now let's summarize the poem once again. The poem is a tribute to the mother's poet's mother. She is looking at an old photograph of her mother, which has a frame of cardboard. The picture has three girls, in which the middle one is the oldest and tallest. It is her mother when she was 12 years old or so. Beside her, on both sides, are her two cousins, Betty and Dolly, who are holding her hands and are younger than her. They went for paddling on a beach holiday. Her uncle took the photograph then. The poet could not help but notice her mother's sweet face. The sea touched her terrible transit feet, which depicted that she changed over the years and the sea remained the same. After 20-30 years later, her mother would laugh at the photograph. She would make the poet look at the photograph and tell her how their parents would dress them up for the beach holiday. The beach holiday was her mother's favorite past memories, while her laugh was the poet's favorite memory. Both of them lost something which they cherished a lot and yet cannot live that moment again. Those sweet moments were memories now. Now, the poet's mother had been dead for the past 12 years, which is the same number as of her age when the photograph was taken back then. She cannot express the grief that she has from her mother's absence. So here we come to the end of this poem. Thank you.